Hey guys, how y'all doing out there? It's time for another review from Pinnacle Studio Pro. Today, I'm bringing you some love from ProDAD. Yeah, ProDRENALIN. This is a program that corrects fisheye for any of those videos that you make with action cameras such as a GoPro. All right, let's get into it. I'm gonna open up ProDRENALIN. And what I do, it gives you some great instructions on the front of the screen, but you got me, baby, so you don't need the instructions. All right, I'm gonna tell you how to get it all done. But first, let's jump off into the lovely interface. Top of the screen, you got your toolbar. Your toolbar houses all of the actions, or most of the actions that you're gonna be taking with this. You got import media, you got your fisheye removal that lets you select a profile of your camera. We'll get into that in a bit. Some great little video effects that you can use. You got your stabilization, view mode, and then your virtual camera adjustments. Right below that in the middle of the screen, you got your preview, and you know what's going to show up there? Your lovely video footage. To the right of that, you have some tabs here. You got an information tab, tells you the information about the clips. You got a clip adjustment tab where you can do some basic color correction. You got your media bin for all of your media that you import into the software. And then your output media for all of the media that you make corrections to. It gives you the location, lets you play with it in the program a little bit. At the bottom of the screen, you got your timeline. Now on your timeline, you have the option to play and stop the media. You can scrub your media from there, and you can also trim your media. Let's bring some of our baked-in media into the program. Three different ways you can go about doing that. All right, you can just open up your media yourself. Hold down your left mouse button and then just drag it in, let it go, and it'll be in there. Another option you got, it tells you right here. Click here to import media. If you click here, you can go to the location you want, bring your media in. Or you can hit import media. So I'm gonna click on import media. Gives me the choices here. I'm gonna select all of these by left clicking the first clip, holding down my shift key, and then left clicking the last clip. It will select all of them. And now I can click open, and it brings all the media in. Now, when you first bring your media in and you look at it, you see this tab here says view optimize. Well, it sure looks like it still got some fish out of me. Well, the issue with that is we haven't selected a profile yet. We need to select the profile for the device that we recorded on. So if you click on this drop down arrow, you see there's a lot of different options on here. A lot of different GoPro, Canon, Sony, all of that. Pick the one that suits what you did. I have a GoPro Silver, so it only goes up to 1080p. Wah, wah. Poor me, right? And I have mine in the housing. So I'm going to pick GoPro 3 in housing 1080. When I click on that, it automatically goes ahead and makes my video look lovely. Fish eye is gone. Now keep in mind, it's not going to have the same amount of things in the footage, because when you correct the fish eye, it has to stretch things out a little bit to make it look right. So of course now you can't see like some of the lights. If I click on view source up here, see that I have more to view. So let's talk about each one of these sections. We already talked about the fisheye removal. Let's go into the video effects presets. A lot of lovely little presets you can use on here. I was kind of surprised. You can go through here and you can just hover over these. You don't have to click on them. If you hover over it, you can see the different type of effect that you get. There's a lot of different things on here. I'm not going to go into all of them, but just keep in mind they're pretty snazzy. You also have the option to stabilize your video. Okay, if it needs to be stabilized, you can just click on that. It'll take you through a function to stabilize it. We'll stabilize the video in a second here. And then you have view optimized or view source. If I want to go back and look at the original video, I can by clicking on that. If I want to see a comparison, I click on horizontal. I get a side-by-side look at the video that is fixed and the video that is not fixed. And you can tell down here, it tells you, this is the side that has been optimized with ProDRENALIN to remove the fisheye. And this is the side that has not been. If you want to look at it vertically instead, just click on vertical compare. And then you get a comparison that way as well. Now, if you want to make any adjustments to the zoom, you can right here. I can zoom in. I can zoom out. Keep in mind, if you zoom out past 100, it's probably going to show some black and things that it used to fix the fisheye. As you can see, this tells you, it gives you a picture of what it actually did to the video to fix the fisheye. Pretty crazy, huh? Let's just get this back to 100. All right, and then if something's off, you need to tilt it, go ahead and tilt it. You got this option right here. If you need to pan, you can pan right or left. And if you want to get your roll on, go ahead and get your roll on. You go clockwise, counterclockwise, however you like. I'm loving all of that right now. Now let's say I was like, I want to stabilize my video. It was a little bit shaky. Some of the footage wasn't that good. What you want to do before you stabilize your video is you want to make all your adjustments, all right? If you don't make all your adjustments first, what's going to happen is it's going to tell you that you got to do it again. All right, so let's go ahead and scrub the timeline here. And I want to find a spot where I actually started moving. And I think this is pretty good here. So I'm going to move this little blue thing over by just left clicking, holding it down, and dragging it to where I want to trim my video. And then I can left click on the timeline and scrub it again to another position that I like. And I like that one there. So I'm going to trim the out point there. And my end point here. And I like what I did. Now, you can also just play this back. See how it looks. See the loveliness of not having fisheye. That's basically why I did this in like a really small room. Because when you do it in a space like this, you can really see the fisheye really, really well. And you can see it if you got a trained eye. You can see if you look really hard too, if it's not in a small space. But this really pronounces it. So I wanted you guys to get a look at how this tool really fixes the fisheye really well. Now that I've trimmed my video, I'm going to click on Stabilize Video. So now it's going to go ahead and stabilize it. For that movement that I had, any bumping, jumping, or whatever, it's going to take care of that for me. Now it's done. I can play it back. Looking all lovely. Let's just stop that where it is. All right, so let's talk about the tabs here. We got our clip adjustments. Now, for clip adjustments, you could do some basic color correction. You can change the brightness. You can change the contrast. You can change the saturation, white balance, all of that goodness. In your media bin, this shows all of the clips that I imported. I can click on any one of these, and then it will take me to that clip. And if I want to do any other adjustments, I can make them. The only thing I don't have to do now is do the fisheye removal. The reason why I don't is because when I pick a profile, it's going to apply that to all of the clips that I brought in. It's assuming that the footage was all done on the same device when you do that. All right, so be careful when you do that. Make sure you only import media from one device when you do this, because you can batch export all of these files at once. If I click on information, you see it's like, well, I'm going to create 5 files, buddy. All right, you brought in 5, I'm going to create 5. But if I go back to the media bin and I uncheck any of them and I go back to information, it's going to say, well, I'm going to just create 1 file now. All right. And then output media bin, that shows the file after we've outputted. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's export this file. So I'm going to click on export to optimize media. And when I click on this, I got some choices. First thing, if I don't click export files to another directory, it's going to put it right in the same place where I got it from. I don't want that. So I'm going to pick a different directory. Just pick a place. You go ahead and click on a folder and you can pick a location. I'm gonna let it just go to that location. I'm fine with that. Then you got your quality. You can pick large, medium, or low. And then if you pick that you want a QuickTime file, you get the same options. And then you can do an MP4. Then you have denoise. If your footage has a lot of noise, you can see all kind of little things, like it look like a bunch of gnats are flying around your footage. Look like you're filmed in Africa or something. There's a bunch of gnats running around. You can denoise it. All right. So if you choose to denoise it, it'll tell you you can't see this until it's exported. It will not preview with the denoise, but you can view it from here. Once you have your file here, you can view it side by side by doing horizontal or vertical, and you can tell the difference in the noise right here in the program, which is cool. I don't have any noise. I don't have a lot of noise in this, so I'm going to leave it as it is. And then I'm going to click on start export. It tells me once again you got one file that you're going to export. So I'm going to click on the button. I already tested this, of course. I'm not a dummy. So I'm just going to click on OK to let it override it. And then we play the waiting game. Now that we're done, we can view the footage in the Windows Media Player if we want to by clicking on that button. It shows us the exported footage. Look at that. Look at how clean that is. Fisheye's gone. Fisheye's not strong when it comes to ProDRENALIN. They need to put me in a commercial or something. All right. Anyway. I'm going to close this out. If there were more files, I could choose these buttons to move it to the next file that I did. But I only did the one. But now, let's say I did choose the denoise filter. I could go ahead and do a horizontal or a vertical comparison between the two. You got the side that has ProDRENALIN, the side that doesn't. And you'd be able to also see any improvements to noise besides just the improvement to the fisheye removal. One last thing on here before I let you go. It says here under the fisheye removal, the camera profile, that you can create a camera profile or edit or import a camera profile. Now, you can't do that unless you have DeFisher, which is another program made by ProDAD. DeFisher cost $100. And all it does is fisheye removal, but it does it really well. It lets you do like any camera. Even if it doesn't have the profile, you can create your own profile based on your camera, which is the splendiferous goodness of choosing DeFisher. But the splendiferous goodness of choosing ProDRENALIN is if you already have a camera that it recognizes it has a profile for, you got a lot more options to do. And the price is only $50 for ProDRENALIN, and it's $100 for DeFisher. All right, now that I broke down the use of the program and gave you the full review, let me give you my marks on what I feel about ProDRENALIN. All right, for features, I'm giving ProDRENALIN the laugh face. I am loving the features that it brings in to this program. It makes fixing that fisheye, rolling shutter, getting it all set up the way you want to, stabilizing, it makes it all easy and it does it in one application. I love it. For functionality, the laugh face. Yeah, that's right, people. I'm loving the functionality. Interface, ease of use, the flow of it is all there. I'm loving it. It makes it real simple to use. One thing I would like, though, is I would love for it to be a plugin for something like maybe Pinnacle Studio. You hear me out there, guys, at ProDAD? You hear me? For price, I'm giving ProDRENALIN the laugh face. That's right, people. 3 for $3 on this software, baby. Price is all good. $50 for all the things that this can do for your action cam videos. You got to jump on it, baby. This is beautiful. This is just, I'm flabbergasted and I don't know what to say. I'm lost. I'm so in love. I'm lost. So basically, you must know that ProDRENALIN gets my software stamp of approval. All right, guys, you know the routine. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments. You know I love comments. If you leave me questions, I'll give you answers. If I can't find the answer, I'll point you in the right direction to get you the help that you deserve. If you need some more Pinnacle Studio love, all you gotta do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. And last, but definitely not least, don't you ever forget to subscribe. Hit the little button on the side. Get your sub on. Get your sub on.